Hello everyone, in this video we are going to discuss sequential search using Python. Sequential search is the very basic search. We have an sorted array or unsorted array. We have some array, sorted array or unsorted array. We want to search a certain item. Say for example, in this unsorted array, I want to search 77. So what I will do, I will start the search from the first item. I will start the search from the first item. If it is not that item, then I will search for the item in the second question or in the third question, fourth question, like that. I will repeat this until I find out, until I find out that particular key, or in some worst cases I may go for up to the last question. I will be checking up to the last question. Even then also the item may not be found. So two possibilities. I'll be identifying the key. I'll be identifying the key and its position. Or in some cases that particular item may not be present in the list. We'll go for a sample code. This is again this is not my own code. I'm just using a user defined function. So def, through define keyword, I'm just defining the function. The function name is sequential underscore search. This particular function takes two inputs. One is the list, which may be, the list which may be a sorted one or unsorted one. The second input is the key, what you want to find out, in the list. So initially the index is 0. We know that in Python the index starts with 0. I am also defining another variable. It's basically boolean, found equal to false. Intentionally I'm just making it to false. I don't know how many items I have to go. So what I'm doing, I'm just defining a while loop. It contains two things. One is this index less than length L and not found. So length L means it tells how many number of elements available in the array. List. For example, if there are five elements, I have some example here. 11, 23, 58, 31, 56, 77, 43, 12, 65, 19. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So totally there are 10 elements. So we know that the index starts from 0. So the last index is 9. So the index should be less than the length of L. For example, it should go from 0 to 9 for this example. And I'm just using logical AND. This should be true and this should also be true. Not found. Found is a boolean. I have initialized with false. Not found means it's true. When both the conditions, when this is true and when the index is less than length of L, I'm going to check whether if L of index, initially index is 0, L of 0 double equal to the key. For example, let me take 31. I want to identify 31. L of 0 is 11. 11 is equal to 31. This condition is not true. So again found is false only, else, okay, I'm just increasing the index. Now the index becomes 1. Okay, index become 1. So again it goes for the while loop. Okay, index 1 less than 10, this is true, and found is not changed, found is false, not found is true, this is also satisfied. Okay, so again I'm just checking if L of index, new index is 1, L of 1 double equal to key. Okay, so L of 1 is 23. Again this is not true. So just index is incremented, now the index is 2. Okay, again I'm just checking while 2 less than 10, yeah this is correct, and okay true, because we have not updated the found. So L of 2, which is 58, I'm just checking whether 58 is equal to 31. Again this is not true, so index is incremented, now the index is 3. So L of 3, so 3 less than 10 while loop, untrue. Okay, so L of 3 which is 31 double equal to 31. Okay, it is true, so found is equal to true. Okay, found is updated to true, it's a boolean, it is updated to true, it won't go for else part. Okay, so it again comes for the while loop index. Okay, index is not updated, so the previous index is 3, so 3 less than 10 it is true, and not found, not true is false. Okay, the condition fails, so it comes out of the while loop. It comes out of the while loop. Okay, so it goes for this particular part. So if found double equal to true, yeah found is true. Okay, the condition is satisfied. Print key. Key is 31. 31 is found at index. Okay, at index 3. Okay, while loop is over up to length 9. In such cases, if the found is found won't be true, if the key is not present in the item, then it will print the else part. Okay, then it will print the else part. We'll go for Python code. Okay, so the same code is available here. I'm just checking. Okay, I'm just a sequential search. I'm just giving this list as the first input, and let me check the same 31. Okay, same 31. We execute this. You just see 31 is found at index 3. Let me go for 19. Okay, the index should be 9. Yeah, we are getting the output. Let me take some element which is not present. Okay, let me take 21. Let me quickly check. 21 is not available here. Execute. Okay, 21 not found. Okay. So what is the complexity of this particular sequential search? Okay, so there are two cases. One is item is present, item not present. Okay, so for each of these cases, what is the best case, worst case, average case? Okay, I have a list with n items. Okay, there are n items in the list from 1 to n. Okay, or index wise if you see 0 to n minus 1, but totally there are n list. Okay, best case, the item is present. Okay, in the first position itself the item is present, so only one search is sufficient, out of n only one. Worst case, okay, the item may be present at the nth position. Okay, so n searches are required, the worst case. Average n by 2, okay, total 10 means 5, something like that, average n by 2. If the item is not present, so obviously whether it is a best case or worst case, we will search for all the items. Okay, so best case is n, worst case is n, average is also n. Okay, average is also n. So if you see for sequential search, the maximum number of search required is, okay, order of n. Okay, totally n searches. Okay, is required. Item is present or item is not present. Okay, maximum I need n searches. Okay, sequential search is very basic search. We'll discuss binary search in the next video. I hope you understood the sequential search and the Python code, corresponding Python code. Thank you.